I thank you for the invitation to your camp. It's, well appointed, not too crowded, perfect for thinking. And I've been doing just that. It's about Wulbryn. We know he's been taken to Moonrise Towers, and we know I'm going to save him. The problem is this. A preponderance of evidence that I am a terrible adventurer. I'm not sure I should trust Wulbryn's fate to, well, me. You've done so much already. I'm hesitant to prevail upon you again, but I can't risk recapture. I barely escaped last time. You'd do it then. You'd look for him. That's very decent of you. Thank you. There's something else you should know. Something I can no longer ignore. I know you've learned about the gnome's pursuit of rune powder, but do you know what it truly is? Until very recently, I thought rune powder was a myth, a substance so powerful it could fell a city, a nation. The Iron Hand gnomes have proven the impossible. Rune powder is real, and they have it in their possession. Destruction. The only thing it's good for. But destruction of what? Well, I'm hoping Wulbryn will be able to tell us. I shouldn't have let him drift away. Shouldn't have let that lot get their claws into him. Now more than ever, I need to find him. We need to find him. He's the only one I might be able to speak to sensibly. I'd kiss you. But neither of us deserve that. Thank you.
Like what?
Alchemist, tinkerer, adventurer, curmudgeon. I wear many hats, most with great enthusiasm. Thank you for noticing. Barkus Root is my name. Baldur's Gate is my home. Back in the city, I offered my expertise to the highest bidder. I was quite popular, too. I'm not picky about my customers. I suppose I'd be very, very sad. Then, after a while, I'd find whoever killed him and put a smoke powder bomb in their trousers.
For me to ask how you fared? Some of my kin have already made it here, safe and sound.
It's past time we were back in the city.
But if you find yourself there, call on us. The Iron Hand gnomes are good friends to have. No fooling you. We've some scores to settle back in the gate. No. But the Iron Hands owe you a different kind of debt. Find us and we'll make good. That, I promise.
Thanks again for offing that drow. Only made it here because of you. But I can't stop thinking about the rest of us. Stuck in Moonrise with a bunch of sadists. Poor bastards.
I don't know half of what they're saying, but at least they're peaceful.
Stopped me yet.
bleeding. I crave blood.
Making me sweat.
Looking ahead. Still breathing, despite everything. Moving in. Anything of use? I'll give it a shot.
Attention!
La la la.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have. Slow down.
I will ascend.
anything up.
Take me yet.
To parley, and he brings a spectator. Twit. Quite ruined my ambush. Now, you are? Rescue? Helpless babes are rescued. I allowed you to assist me. I am Dawn, third son of House Bartol, first rank evoker, and initiate of Graven Hollows. Oh. Oh, no, no, my dear dark gods below, no! A memory shard. They hold their glow for years. And it's fading. It contains knowledge that is precious to me. If it has grown this dull, then my enemies have already found the forge. Which bastard stole my glory? Zargrim? Philro? Impossible. My rivals would have stopped at nothing. Unless... Huh. Ha! The fools must have turned back, or, better yet, died in the search. Good. If they had just surrendered their research to me, we might have found the forge together. But no. They hoarded their knowledge, left each of us clinging to scraps. I had the good sense to lock mine away in the shard. And now I can claim the forge alone. They knew of the forge's defenses, its operation, true enough. But I know its location. The rest I can figure out with time. Now I am the only one searching. Or almost the only one. You proved your power in freeing me. But I need no more rivals. Try to take this as a compliment, yes?
Thank you.
Victory awaits.
Inside. Very well.
Trap. Be cautious.
The crystal shines only faintly. A memory shard the wizard had cooked. The crystal's glow swells, drawing you into its depths. You are transported. Somewhere deep, loud, and hot as the hells themselves.
Within the Underdark's bowels, beyond an ancient stronghold, hovers a giant hammer waiting to fall.
An echoing clang, and you're back to yourself, left only with a firm sense of a place, a grand forge.
Step is the hardest. That's curious. Room for more?
The wall is riddled with holes. A suffocating stench of long rotten meat wafts out. You recognize the odor. The foul scent of carrion crawlers, centipede-like aberrations that feast on the dead. At one time, these caverns must have been their banquet hall. The creatures are either long gone or waiting patiently in the darkness. The passage narrows and bends, becoming impassable before you're even elbow deep.
Empty. The bone, dry and brittle.
The wall is riddled with holes. A suffocating stench of long rotten meat wafts.
Nothing but rocks. Empty.
Someone there?
With pleasure.
Bunch of empty boxes and spiderwebs. Guess Lolth's cultists don't live back here in a while. Still breathing, despite everything. Best be on my way. Watch how you go. There's a trap. Hold on.
Time to get going.
On my way. Better not be cursed. one's stopped me yet. Maybe I need more pockets. Watch how you go. There's a trap. With a flick of the wrist? Thank you.
oceans. O blessed Boal. Our bones to build your temple in the deep.
A wave of pure devotion washes over you. And with every surge, you feel a presence grow in response.
Word, priest. Promi says, your god wants proof. Wants blood.
These beings are Kuatoa, former Mind Flayer slaves that manifest their gods through sheer belief.
You! Lord of Murder demands sacrifice. You will be an offering for the great god Boal.
That's so, Cutlet. I'm a god, and I fancy a bit of murder. Simple enough. Well, priest, Boal wants a sacrifice. Boal wants blood!
Thank you. need to learn the hard way.
This is my happy place.
Cry about it.
In position.
Despite everything. To the chase.
Mavir!
Poor old Buar wasn't long for this world after all.
Thank you.
story.
There we go.
Assume nothing.
What now?
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have. I have to keep going. That'll fit in my pack. To ignite these. Strange.
Easy.
What are they? Moving ahead. Traps, please. Let's see what this does. Idea, I think.
Sounds like the owner was quite the literary type. I'll take that.
Something?
Deep and move. No one back home will ever believe this.
Hmm.
hiding here? Things have stayed interesting. No time to rest. Light on my feet. Here goes nothing.
A disc appears in your mind's eye. Lazelle sees it too and considers the vision.
Tirsu markings. Ancient. I recognize them, but I can't make sense. No. Wait. The texts are enciphered, but I've solved the pattern. It's a story. About Orpheus.
Your head buzzes in concert with Lazelle's, but it hardly matters. Even without the connection, you'd recognize her discomfort.
A traitor. A dead one. This text is heresy. I can hardly bear to read it, let alone speak it. Very well. I will read it to you. The Prince of the Comet, Part 1. So it was that we were free from Geich shackles and turned our blades on each other. The heavens were shattered, and one great empire was divided in two. Gith traveled to the Hells to broker help for her people, her cause. Vlakith would have you believe Mother Gith proclaimed her our queen. Lies. Gith made no such proclamation. Vlakith seized the empire against the Mother's wishes. But Gith had nurtured a son, Orpheus, Prince of the Comet, the true heir. He knew Vlakith's treachery. Orpheus rallied Gith's honor guard and declared the throne for himself. The War of the Comet had begun. Disregard this drivel. Gith declared Vlakith queen of the Empire and her own son defied her. Orpheus would have ceded control to the Geich. She did nothing of the sort. Thank your good fortunes I'm a tolerant woman, or I'd have sliced off a few toes for suggesting it.
What a charmer. That's right.
Still alive, so that's progress. Oh, wish I had a bag of holding.
Place for a button, especially one that doesn't work. returns to the dark oppression ring. Is it the foul? That foul, contemptuous heel?
You know these words. They are from the opening stanza of a play you found in this very tower.
Come out of love for me, not love for blood and steel. Command as you see fit, my lord. If you do not believe the secret show, reveal the truth. Do what you wish to see.
What now?
Somehow you...
Need to find a way forward.
Thanks, boss.
Yes.
We'll be looking a lot.
She is cataloguing Coatuan fertility rituals.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? I do enjoy a good bargain. Very well. I have mushrooms to catalog.
I greet you, child of the sun. How has your search for the mushrooms fared? These are fine specimens. It will only take me a moment to brew them to proper potency.
Omeluum turns away to prepare the potion, lost in its own musings.
You must drink the entire draught. I can make no promises as to its taste. It will lower the psionic defenses around the lava. If I cannot remove it, I may still be able to tell you more about its origin.
Omeluum watches you with cautious intensity. It expects doubt. It expects fear.
Only in that you may be a danger to yourself. What the potion may make you see or feel, I cannot determine. But unless you are already a step from death, it will not kill you.
The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. Dark holes bite at the edges of your vision, but the void cannot draw you in. The temple spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. Lose their edge. You are stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluum, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. Such an outcome was not in my calculations. There is more to this being than mere stasis. Indeed. Although, I may have another solution, albeit a temporary one. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn? A fascinating topic indeed. What can you tell me? What a brilliant experience. To feel one step closer to my ancestors is a fine gift indeed. Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me.
To deal with this abomination, nigh unthinkable. Yet even Vlakith herself could not deny the ring's merit.
Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth. I have never seen anything like it, Blur. Is my species evolving?
Somehow you look worse than last episode.
Thanks, boss.
Blackets will be done.
Let's get going.
How was your more personal research progressing?
Not well. The nutrition my species receives from other mines